Hello students, this is Dr. Pankaj Sailoth here. Hope you are safe and staying at home. Now we'll start our video lecture series for course Computer Aided Manufacturing. In this series of the videos, we'll cover various topics related to the course. So first we'll start with the quantitative analysis in group technology and cellular manufacturing. So this topic has been divided into the two parts, part one and part two. So in this video, I will cover the part one, in which we'll focus on the rank order clustering technique for grouping parts and machines. So as we have covered the some of the basics from the group technology and cellular manufacturing, again, I will just go through the some of the basics of these both the technologies, and then we'll move to the this rank order clustering technique. Now these are the quantitative analysis, and followed by this I will make a separate video for the other quantitative analysis. Now when we'll deal with the basics of the group technologies, so group technology mainly is a manufacturing philosophy in which mainly we first identify the similar parts and then group them together to take the advantage of their similarities in the design and production. So those components which are similar in the design, we try to keep them together to take the advantage of those parts. And in this mainly similar parts are arranged into the part families, which is just shown in the figure left side. So it's these different components have the similarities, mean they are cylindrical in the nature. We can perform the manufacturing operation on the lathe machine by all these all have the sort of holes. So we can use the lathe machine and we can perform the different operations. So these will come in the parts, one kind of the part family. The right side, if you'll see, these are the different category of the parts which we can keep in the another part families. And then each part family's own similar design and let's say for the manufacturing characteristic. Now in this, why we let's say this part family gives the advantages. So if you look the first top figure in which it's a factory layout, you can say, where you are receiving this raw materials and the different operations are going on for the turning machine. There are a couple of turning machines here, then moving to the different milling machine, the drilling machines, and there is a random combination where the part is moving from one machine to the other machine. And different operations are taking place, and at the end, the material is coming out as a final product. Now, the advantage of this part families, what it will give is, what you can do is, you can arrange your machine in such a way so that one sort of part which has the similarities in the design will move for the similar path. So that you can keep the simple routines and you can arrange your machines in a such a way, first turning machine, then milling machine, and then drilling machine, and finally assembly, and then it will go out. So this gives the advantage, it saves a lot of time, it's efficient, or let's say provide the in terms of the cost also, it saves the investment cost. Now this will look other basic thing which we have already covered is the cellular manufacturing. So cellular manufacturing is, you can say, some sort of application of the group technologies in which we are now grouping the production equipments also, which have the similarities in the design to execute the operation on the part families. So this is the, you can say, the part family, the parts that have similar processing requirement for the geometrical shapes. In this, we arrange the machine cells. So machine cells is a cluster of dissimilar machines placed in a close proximity and dedicated to the manufacturing of the family of parts. So those, the family which we have made, now we'll arrange the different machines also so that we can execute the operation efficiently. Now in this, we'll, when we talk about the quantitative analysis in the group technology of cellular manufacturing, so there are various number of techniques available to deal with the problems related to the group technology of cellular manufacturing. Mainly we'll focus on the two techniques. The part in this video will focus on the part one, rank order clustering technique for the grouping parts and the machine. So what we have seen, how create those part families and then those machines cells. And then in the second part, which will be the followed videos, this will be the Hohler method for arranging machines in the group technology cells. So how to arrange those machines in a different cells. So first we'll start now with the first part, rank order clustering technique. So first we'll look here two different, let's say the matrix, where the parts have different parts are there, A, B, C, D up to I. These are the different parts. And then we have the different machines from 1 to 7. Now these different parts have the different interaction with the different machines. So A part has the interaction with the machine A, D part has the interaction with machine 1, and then part E have the interaction with the machine 2. Wherever we don't see any number, it's mean there is no interaction between, let's say for the B part does not have the any interaction with the machine 1. Now this kind of the combination of the parts and the machine interaction, it's very difficult to deal with where the part will move, how to arrange the machine, how to arrange, let's say, the different parts. So what we can do is we can apply the quantitative analysis in which we can make the part families and arrange in a such a way so that now this same combination of the operation can be performed in such a way after putting in the part family. It's mean C, E and I parts interacts with the machine 3, 2 and 6. So we can keep this in a single cell, and similar to this, we can keep part A, D, H with the machine 1, 5 and 1, 5, so that we can have the smooth interaction and we can arrange the machine in such a way. So this will be the role of the this technique. And how to do this? This is the technique which we are using, is the rank order clustering technique. Now this technique is specifically we use, or let's say this is applicable in the production flow analysis, where the material is getting flow in the production. So it's, this technique is an efficient and easy to use algorithm for the grouping machines into cell. Now how this machines, or let's say this technique works, is this mainly work based on sorting rows and columns of the machine part incidence matrix. So the matrix which I have showed you, we call as a machine part incidence matrix. And then different steps of this algorithm is explained here. The, in the first step, we assign the binary weight for the each element of row. And then we calculate a decimal weight for the each row using the formula, which is given here. Now these steps I will explain while taking the example also. So this formula, where the M is the number of columns, and then the B is the binary number, which can be 0 and 1. Mainly in this, we just saw 1. Wherever the value is empty, it means that is 0. So this will be the first step. So after applying this formula, what we do is we rank the rows from top to bottom in order of decreasing decimal weights. So there will be decimal numbers will be given. We will arrange from top to bottom in a decreasing manner. And then after doing this, we follow this same step for the column. So first assign the binary weight for each element of column and then calculate the decimal weight while using this formula. So this formula is quite similar to the previous one, where here now n is the number of rows and b is the binary numbers. After using this formula, again we also rank the column from left to right in order of decreasing the decimal weight values. Now in this, we continue this process for these steps until there is no change in the position of each element of the row and column. Now these, there are, let's say, the mainly four steps, two for the column, two for the rows, and then we repeat if there is a changes occurring in the row and column. Now we'll take an example for the rank order clustering technique. So this figure shows the part machine incidence matrix. So this matrix already I have explained, it's me. A part has interaction with the machine A. Similar to this, this E part has the interaction with the machine 3. Now how to arrange this, let's say, parts in the part families. So for this purpose, we are using here the rank order clustering technique. So now we'll apply this algorithm step by step. So first step is assign binary weight. So binary, we know, let's say, in the form of, let's say, the you can say here the binary is 1, 0. The weight will be as per the formula we will define, 2 to the power 0, 1, 2, up to 2 to the power 8. So the 8, if you look, it's like a number of here column. So it will be 9. The formula is 9 minus 1. So this will be 8. Now this is the decimal binary values has been given here. And then similar to that, we'll here calculate the what is the decimal equivalent for that. So this multiplied by this number, and then all the summation when we do, so this is the decimal equivalent value, which is, let's say, for the row one is the 290, and then for the other rows it's given here. Now what we do is, this is the first step only, we assign binary weight and then calculate the decimal weight. Now in the second step, we provide the rank here. So rank meaning will be, there are total 7 machines. Now based on this, from top to bottom, high to low values of the decimal weight. So first, this is the, let's say, the our let's say matrix. Now the second step we are want to apply here. So in this, we'll divide this in the rank for the order of decreasing decimal weights. So which will be this. So that will be defined here, the these rank 1, 7, 5, 4, 2, 6, and 3. Now while using this number, we will exchange that. So first rank will come first, then the second one. So this time machine fifth will move up. So according to that, we will arrange this. So machine fifth is moved up, then 7, then 4. So this combination has been now changed, which was original. Now we'll apply the same process on the column. Now in this column, we again provide this binary values for individual element, and then we calculate the decimal equivalent. So these decimal equivalent, which are now given here, we provide the rank. So maximum, or let's say, the highest value is 1, and then least will be the 7. Now in this, we arrange this matrix, and then finally when we arrange this, we get this. So it's like a, now order has been changed for the parts and the machine in such a way so that we see the similarities of the part which have the interaction with the machines are together. So this is, let's say, we have arranged the parts and the machine to make a family, and this is the purpose of the using the rank order clustering technique. And this technique is very useful and efficient techniques. Similar to this, you will study. So these are the few references which I use. Thank you. So this, the assignment also has been given on this. Hope you like this video. Thank you.